Hey y'all, Oro Crimson here, with the Clannad quote-unquote Let's Play. If you guys saw my last video, my little weird important information video, then you kind of saw this coming. If you didn't, then well, surprise! Anyway, two special guests here today. We have Kunadi Noha.
Hello.
You may know him from the Castlevania LP as James, or from the recent Street Fighter 4 debacle. And then we have my...
That was amazing.
And then we have my brother Ikazu.
Hello!
Debacle.
And here we have Clannad, and we're gonna jump into a new game, and we're gonna see how things go and see what path I'll get, because I'm doing this completely blind. Well, I wouldn't say completely, I did see the anime, so... But it's mostly blind.
So, is this like a first-person shooter, like... freaking Call of Duty style?
Did you really just ask that?
Someone's Skype's going off.
It's not mine. I'm on Do Not Disturb.
Kunadi, you should get on Do Not Disturb.
Okay.
Alright, so we're gonna start now, and I read this stuff, so guys, you guys stay quiet when I read it. Later on, you guys might voice act or whatever, I don't know. I was wondering if TK would voice Akio. It would be kind of funny.
That would be amazing. If not, I want to do it.
Anyway.
I'll be the lowly.
Can we start now?
Okay.
Yes.
Snow. Yes, snow. Continuing to fall... Damn it, Kunadi!
What'd I do? Read the freaking words on the blue.
I could have sworn I heard you smirking or something. I'm like, ugh! Knocked me out of my game, man. Continuing to fall down even now, it covers my body in white. What am I doing in such a world? Since when have I been alone in this place? Buried in snow was my hand. That hand was holding something. I pull it up. A hand of pure white. It was a girl's hand. Ah, that's right. I was not alone. I brushed off the snow covering her face. Her figure, which slept quietly, surfaced. That's right. We were always together. In this world. In this sad, lonely world.
Interesting way to start it.
Depressing. I guess, yeah, it kind of is. Okay.
How do you forget that you're with somebody? You just grab her hand, you're like, oh, that's right.
I hate this town. Because it's a place stained with memories I want to forget. Every day, going to school, chatting with friends, then going to a home I don't like. Nothing new ever happens. I wonder if anything will ever change like this. I wonder if my life will ever be any different. Oh, hell yes it will. The untouched and Napa growth of this town. Weaving around hills to get to school. I wonder how convenient it would be to attend school if you could wipe off all these hills. If I could take a straight path, it would probably cut down my walking time by 20 minutes.
But the nature buffs would not be happy.
One day, 20 minutes, so then how much time will I save in a year? I do the math as I walk. I don't know. There aren't any other students from my school around. Normally, since this is the main path to school, we should be bristling with them. It's not like today is a holiday or anything. Which means, now it isn't the time for people to be arriving at school. I ignore this laid-back image, though. Continue walking at the same speed. 200 meters until I reach the school gates. I stand for a bit. Taking a breath, I look up at the sky. Presented by Key!
Is that in the sky?
That is in the sky. It's a wonderful sky. The school gates are just ahead. We decided to put the gates up all the way up there.
In the sky.
This long road stretching out like a nightmare. It's a different breath of mine. Smaller. More gentle. I look beside me.
There is a girl, standing as still as I am. Okay, I want to warn you guys, so that you don't interrupt during some of this. They do have... Now, unfortunately, my guests here, they can't hear the sound right now. They do have voice acting, as Levi knows. So I will be waiting for the Japanese voice to go through before I do mine. So just be mindful not to speak during that.
Okay.
I can tell that she's a third-year student by the color of her badge. But she isn't someone I know. Her short hair is fluttering in the wind, just above her shoulders. She looks like she's about to cry. I don't usually judge people by appearance, but she looks very honest. She looks like the kind of girl who would be too timid to enter the classroom alone. Okay. She closes her eyes and nods repeatedly for a few moments, as if she had something to tell herself. Then, she opens her eyes. She looks at the tall gate with a firm eye. Do you like this school? Eh? No, she probably wasn't speaking to me. She was probably talking to someone inside her heart. How would this man, or perhaps woman, answer her? I really, really do. But nothing can remain the same forever. Even fun things, happy things, nothing. Nothing stays that way forever. Hold on, guys. Alright, let's do this. With great difficulty, she continues to speak. Even so, can you still like this place? You just have to find it, right? Huh? Surprised, she looks at me. As if she believed that she was alone until now. You just have to find the next fun or happy thing, right? It's wrong to think that there's only one thing like that. That's right. There were times when we were innocent and naive. It's a phase everyone goes through. Come on, let's go. I can't read that.
I can. No, I'm lying.
But I can imagine it is very epic and amazing considering it's coming up in slow motion with a white screen.
Oh, dude, that's like telling you that, you can't read
it's,
this.
It's
you
April 14th. Too much Japanese. I think it's April 14th right now.
Tsunohara!
Tsunohara! The teacher calls out the name of a single student. Absent as usual. I glance at Tsunohara teacher beside me. Boy! You just interrupted me.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh, shit's just going down.
I'm joking. I glance at Tsunohara's seat beside me. His attendance is even worse than mine. We are the only... Whoa. You moving around, Clannad?
No.
Because there was a lot of noise coming from you.
Die.
We are the only two students in this class known as delinquents. I guess that's why we get along. Also, he's the only person that can really talk to you freely. That's how we are. The lesson has started. I spent my time looking out the window, ignoring everything the teacher's saying.
What a dick.
The class has ended, and school is over. That Tsunohara didn't show up at all. In the end, the only person I talked to today was the girl from this morning. Today is no different from any other day. I'm not part of any clubs, so I pick up my empty bag and slip out the classroom while the rest of the students are chatting away. Even if I go home, there won't be anyone there right now. I don't have a mother to begin with. She died in a car accident when I was young. I don't even remember her face. My father, who was left behind, sank into depression, probably affected by the shock of her death. He'd go out, get drunk, and waste his time gambling. My entire childhood was wasted from always fighting with him. But after a certain incident, our relationship changed. He became violent and injured me. From that day forward, my father kept his thoughts to himself. Then, instead of calling me in the normal way, he started calling me Tomoyaku, with a kun at the end, as though I were a stranger. I don't think coon is what you'd use exactly for a stranger, but I do know it's not what you'd call your child.
Oh no, it's Japan. They can do with whatever they want with their words.
Without a doubt, that made us feel unrelated. Go on, Levi.
I was just gonna say, I agree with Kanadi. Japan does some weird crap.
Yeah, well, this is also an English translation. And there's no official one, so this is a fan translation.
Ah.
It's a really... It's pretty accurate for a fan translation. It's the only translation there is, and as far as I know. It's like the best translation there is. But, they're,
it's made by
they're,
fans.
They're going to make a mistake then and there. It just happens. They did that with the dub. I mean, it's no big deal. Just like a closed shell. Just like a point in time that separates the present from the past. It would have been better if he had just completely ignored me. If he cared enough to cause me pain, there would still be hope. But now, if he sees me come home, he smiles as if seeing an old friend and begins to chat. It would cause me so much pain that I couldn't take it anymore. I would rush out of the house. And so, in order to avoid him, I had lived my life not returning home until late at night, after he was asleep. I go to sleep at dawn and wake up around noon. Ever since I entered high school, I've always been late. This has been going on for 3 years. Today, as always, I changed my clothes and left before my father got home. That's what I've become used to. I roam around the town at night, and I end up going to the same place at the end of the day. I buy my dinner at the Canadian store, and with it in hand, I head down to the school slope, towards the student dormitory. The school actively promotes club activities, so there are a lot of students here. They spend their 3 years here away from their parents. They are very different from a person who lives out of school life, with no dreams, like me. It's none of my business, but in this place, Sunohara lives here. Even Sunohara got into the school for sports, as he was once a part of the soccer team. But in his first year, he got into a big fight with students from another school and got suspended. He was removed from being a regular player. And then, after his freshman year, he lost his place on the team. There was nothing he could do but leave them. As he couldn't really afford to move anywhere else, he ended up remaining in this dorm, which is reserved for students of sport clubs. How many times do I have to tell you? But the volume was really low. Sunohara is there. He's in front of another room talking with a student with a huge body. Even if it's really low, I can hear it through these tin walls. Use your headphones. I told you I can't afford that. Then don't listen to it. No, but if I don't, then I can't really get in the mood, you know? And it's a really cool song, you know?
No.
Look, if you'll just listen to the lyrics, you'll know what I mean. I don't care what the hell you mean. All you're doing is pissing me off. If I hear it again, I'm kicking you out of here. Slam. Sunohara's head slumps down before the closed door. You know, they do the voice. They do, like, okay. I'm gonna stop doing sound effects, considering they already do that for me. Damn, that rugby player. Well, I mean, like, sound effects and, like, when they go eek and stuff. The slam I actually had to do. He mumbles to himself. He's not going to hear you like that. Damn that rugby player! I correct him with a yell as he stands beside me. Sunohara grabs me by the head and drags me into his room.
Ew.
In the hallway, a large voice bellows. Who the hell was that? Are you trying to get me killed? You're the one who said that, aren't you? You know, Okazaki. I'm not on good terms with the residents here these days. Wow, that was longer than I expected it to be. Him saying it in Japanese. So let's go all out right now.
He's
still got a year left. You really don't have any guts, do you? Hey! I wouldn't back down in a one-on-one fight, even if it's with a rugby player. I screwed that up, I said it while you were still saying it. Thought it was done. But all the rooms around here are rugby player rooms. If I stir up something here, it's going to be too dangerous. But, well, when it's near graduation, going all out would be nice. When that time comes, I'll have you cover my back, Okazaki. Lucky, I'll stab you well. Not me, go at them! But I'm on the rugby team side, you see. Since when? Well, just that time. What? Why? What have we been doing for the past 2 years, huh? Dong?
Dong.
The screen shook for Dong?
That's funny.
It's because it's one letter short of Dongo, so they had to, like, show its epicness.
The wall shakes. An angry shout saying, "Be quiet!" follows after that. Apparently, Dong was supposed to be hitting the wall.
I would expect more bang.
I know.
Or crash.
And I'll kick back. Don't do it! You're way too jumpy. Please, try to put yourself in my position, will you? He's
crying.
He's crying. You know, I was just thinking, maybe I should do the Team 4-star Krillin voice for Sunohara.
Why? He's not that pathetic.
Yes, he is.
Yes,
no!
He is.
No! Sunohara is the best. He's blonde, and he has hair, unlike Krillin.
I'm begging you, just shut up, please! Oh, okay. That miserable look is overpowering me. Munch. Began eating from my lunchbox, sitting between the kotatsu and the wall of the small room. Tea, please. I don't have any. That's why I said please, right? I don't care even if you bow. I said I don't have any. You're not confusing this room with a cafeteria, are you? This is your room, I know. Okay. And you're my slave. You don't seem to get it, do you? Come on, man, I've got to buy it. Didn't it ever even occur to you that you should get it yourself? But you said helping me is your only purpose in life ever since I saved you, right? Not such a made-up backstory. Didn't you say it like this after I saved you? The man called Sunohara died at that moment. The person here right now, this is someone who will serve you tea. So, tea. Don't make up such crap! Then I'll settle for the last cup of tea. There's no such thing as first or last! Oh god, this is touching. If you listen to this, you'll definitely want to get tea from me. Losing the battle against the fatal injury, there was no hope left of saving you. And in that condition, you were committed to bringing me tea, for I was thirsty. From there, you squeezed out every last ounce of your strength as you crawled up to me. Pour some tea. And then, Master Okazaki, here's some tea. And this will be your last tea. You were smiling when you died. And I was so damn satisfied with that, huh? That was when you hoped for after all. And then, while crying, I drank that last cup of tea. Touching, isn't it? So, tea. I said I don't have any!
That was boss.
That was boss. They should have done that in the actual anime. That was awesome. After that, I spent the rest of the day reading magazines. There wasn't a TV to watch, so there was nothing to do except read.
Magazines.
Time to go to sleep. The sun has already set, and it's nighttime. Yeah, you're right. I don't plan on sleeping in Sunohara's room. If I wake up seeing this guy in the morning, I'll just be depressed. Then I'm gonna go take a shower. Okay. Tsunohara grabs a towel from mounted clothing in the corner and leaves the room. I want to avoid having to see Tsunohara when he gets back. I guess I should go home. I stop reading the magazine and get up. Then I notice a cassette player in front of me. Looks like there's a tape inside. So, I push the play button. This is old-fashioned hip-hop. Disgusting. Who's gonna listen to this crap? Okay, since you guys can't hear me, Levi, or Igazu.
Yes.
Jeez, I probably should have avoided saying your real name. Okay, Igazu. This music that they're playing here is the music of when Tsunohara first confronts Momoyo. And they're playing it here. Apparently he's got a tape cassette with it. So.
Okay, I don't really remember what music plays there, but alright.
Okay, so you'll just hear when the video comes in.
Yeah.
Dub something over it. Don't do it. Oh!
Yeah! 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 Choices! Choices! Oh, the decisions!
This doesn't happen in the anime! We don't have anything to go off of here!
Okay. Should we piss him off, or should we just leave?
Tsunohara, he's our butt monkey. We gotta do it.
No, but Tsunohara's cool. He's a cool guy.
Tsunohara is like... He's like between Rivel and Krillin.
This is really important decisions here. Viewers.
Oh man, no pressure.
Viewers.
No pressure.
You'll text your answer to the invisible number on screen, and we'll get back to you on our choice after the break. Okay.
This video's been going for a while. We could just stop it now, have some people post some comments, and just make the choice next time.
Here's the thing, I don't have that many viewers.
Yeah, man.
You have me and Kunadi.
Yeah, but we're expendable.
Okay, so the break is over, and we've gotten your votes. And we've gotten a tally of 2-1 for Dub Something Over It.
What? Fine. Just dub something over it.
Okay, I'll record my own original rap instead. Oh, this is gonna suck.
Oh, this will be awesome. It'll be great.
The theme will be to my best friend, Tsunohara rap. This will definitely impress him.
I got some tea. You were my bitch.
This will definitely impress him. Here we go. I take a deep breath and press the record button. Yo, I'm Okazaki, you're... With the tempo down, I begin to spin my words. You're... Damn, nothing comes to mind. Forget it. This is stupid. I throw a swift punch in frustration. Why the hell do I have to do something like this for him anyway? It's not like we're close friends or anything to begin with. I'm out of here.
Isn't he like your only friend?
I decide to leave before Tsunohara returns. That could have been so awesome, and he bailed on it.
Man, if I was him, I would have been all like, yo, this is Okanashi, and you're...
You take Okanashi?
What the... Her face.
She's there again.
You said Otanashi.
Okay, guys. This is gonna be episode one. I'm gonna stop episode one here because I got dinner, so I gotta stop episode one.
And it's April 15th.
It's Tuesday. April 15th, Tuesday. Yeah, that is crazily close to our day. It's in the month of April.
Yeah.
So. I'm going to stop the video. We'll see you guys in episode 2. I have been Oro Crimson.
This is Ikazu129.
And this is Kunai Noah.
I was about to say, you better say something before I'll pitch slap you. Okay. Wow, I usually don't curse online, and I just did. Okay, so that would be about it, guys. See you next time. I really hope you guys enjoy. Later.
Don't forget to eat a burrito.
Face.
Don't forget to eat a burrito. No,
so beautiful.